my friends, welcome to a new episode of our series History of the Church. Today we are going to talk about the early fathers of monasticism, who was Saint Anthony, Saint Paul, Saint Pachomius, and many others. Let's start directly by talking about the first hermit, Saint Paul of Thebes. Saint Paul of Thebes was born in a city called Thebes, which is currently Luxor in Egypt. He lived between the year 228 AD to the year 343 AD. At the age of 15, his parents died, and he went into conflict with his brother-in-law about the heritage of his father. And one day, while he was walking in his town, he saw a funeral of one of the rich men of this town. Immediately, he decided to start the life of seclusion. He dropped the case with his brother-in-law, and he left all the wealths of the world for the sake of the higher and heavenly kingdom. He is considered the first hermit. He spent like 90 years in seclusion without seeing any human being. In the last days of his life, he met with Saint Anthony the Great, who wrote his story and was buried with two lions in the garment of Saint Athanasius, as requested from Saint Anthony. May his intercessions be with us all. Amen. Now we are going to talk about Saint Anthony the Great, the founder of the eremitical monasticism and the father of all the monks in our world today. Saint Anthony was born in Bani Suif, Egypt, in the year 251 AD and departed in the year 356 AD. He belonged to a rich family. At the age of 20, he entered the church to attend the liturgy, and he heard our Lord Jesus Christ saying in the Gospel, in the book of Matthew chapter 19 and verse 21, "If you want to be perfect, go sell what you have and give to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven, and come follow me." Immediately Saint Anthony felt that this is his calling, and he went and he sent his possessions and he headed to the desert. As his history tells, that Saint Anthony received the garment of the monks through a vision of an angel. He saw an angel that is praying and wearing the garment of the monks and also doing some labor work. So he started to follow his lead, and so forth all the monks in the world started to follow the same model that Saint Anthony established. Also gradually, many youths started to follow the road of Saint Anthony, and he became the father of many, many monks. Saint Athanasius the Apostolic, as we said, the Patriarch number 20, became the disciple of Saint Anthony for 6 years and wrote about his life. Saint Anthony left his cell and his life of seclusion twice. The first time was in the era of the Great Persecution, between the years 303 and 311. He went to Alexandria to encourage the Christian believers to stay in the Christian faith. The second time was during the era of Saint Athanasius the Apostolic, where the church was fighting against the heresy of Arius. So Saint Athanasius asked Saint Anthony to come to encourage the believers, and he did so. So we can see that the monks and the great church fathers had a great role to support and encourage the Christians during the different persecutions. Saint Anthony, as I said, is still remembered worldwide as the father of all male monks, and later on Saint Benedict in Europe will be affected greatly by the life of Saint Anthony and establish the monastic life in Europe. May his intercessions be with us all. Amen. Now we move to talk about Saint Synclatica, which is considered the mother of all female nuns in the world. She lived almost in the era of Saint Anthony, and also we had her story written by Saint Athanasius the Apostolic. She was born originally in Macedonia, Greece, in the mid of the 3rd century, and she died around the year 350 AD after she lived for 80 years. When she was young, she moved with her family to the city of Alexandria, Egypt, due to the great reputation of Alexandria, because at that time the city of Alexandria was famous for many things, including the philosophical schools and the library of Alexandria, and also the theological school of Alexandria. After the death of her parents, she went together with her sister and she started to live in the grave of her parents, and step by step she moved into the wilderness. And as Saint Athanasius told us, she had a great life striving against the demons, and she reached a very high level of spirituality, which encouraged a lot of females to follow her lead. May her intercessions be with us all. Amen. Now we move to talk about Saint Pachomius, the founder of the Cenobite monasticism. He was born in the year 292 AD in Thebes, Luxor, and departed in the year 348 AD. The name Pachomius is a Coptic word, means the eagle. He was born to a pagan family and became a Roman soldier, and during one of the military missions to Upper Egypt to stop the riots against the emperor, he was overwhelmed by the way the Christians deal with the army. So he decided to be a Christian, and he later on got baptized in the early of his 20s. By the year 318, Saint Pachomius founded the first monastery, and under his supervision, as history tells us, he had around 1800 monks and 300 nuns. He created the rules of the Cenobite monasticism and founded the rank of the abbot. In his life as well, many nationalities started to join the Cenobite monasticism, as is still used until today. May his intercessions be with us all. Amen. Now we move to talk about Saint Macarius the Great. Saint Macarius the Great was born in Minouf, Egypt, around the year 301 and departed in the year 391 AD. At his early age, he loved the life of seclusion and chastity, and he was influenced greatly by the great Saint Anthony. But his parents forced him to get married, but he kept his chastity, and shortly his wife departed, and later on he decided to go into the wilderness. He was the first to dwell in the Nitrian Valley, and gradually many monks followed his lead and gathered around him. He was also exiled in the era of the Arian Emperor Valens due to his Orthodox faith. May his intercessions be with us all. Amen. And finally, we are going to talk about Saint Shenouda, the head of the Anchorites. Saint Shenouda, the chief of Anchorites, lived between the year 348 AD and departed in the year 466 AD. He was born in Upper Egypt, and the name Shenouda means the servant of God. He became a monk at very early age due to the guidance of his uncle Saint Bigol, and he founded the White Monastery. He also had a role in spreading the Coptic dialect of Ikmim in Egypt for centuries to come. And also we notice there are many sermons for Saint Shenouda during the Holy Week. We read them all many times during the Holy Week. He attended the Council of Ephesus in the year 431 AD based on the request of Saint Cyril, the pillar of faith, to respond to the heresy of Nestorius. May their intercessions all be with us all. Amen. Now you can see on the screen many references if you want to dig deeper on the topics that we discussed today in our episode. Thank you for watching. Pray for us. Bye.